call for help, okay? Can I get some help in room 605, please?
Oh my goodness, Mrs. Smith, what happened?
I got up to go to the bathroom and
urgent
I got dizzy.
Urgent broadcast 6-4 fall alert team.
I got dizzy and next thing I knew I was on the floor. I think I may have hit my head and hurt my arm.
Okay, well, let's just do a quick assessment. And how bad is your pain right now if you had to give it a number?
A 7.
Okay, let's get you back into bed. Can you grab a set of vital signs? And as I start doing those vital signs, maybe if you could grab the lift equipment so we can get her safely into bed, okay?
No problem.
All right, so I'm going to let the doctor know that you fell. All right, and let's get you safely taken care of. Okay.
Is everybody all right?
Yeah.
Let's debrief and engage the patient in this process so we can hear what happened. Patrice?
I was in the hallway doing rounds when I walked by Mrs. Smith's room and I saw her on the floor. She was in a sitting position with her head against the wall. She was crying out for help, so I immediately got the nurse for help.
Yeah, I heard Patrice calling and I used my voice error to call an urgent broadcast fall alert team and announced that it was in room 605.
Is the patient okay? Are there any injuries?
Mrs. Smith thinks she might have hit her head. She also isn't sure if she did or didn't. She is on an anticoagulant, so we should probably follow up with a head injury protocol. She's also complaining of a right arm pain. I called Dr. Mahaldra, and he's on his way down.
Are there any histories of falls that we know of?
Not during this hospital stay, but a history of falls at home.
Was the patient a fall risk? If so, was her bundle in place?
Yes, she is an 85-year-old female on anticoagulation therapy. She's been placed on the fall risk bundle. She has her yellow socks, her bracelet. The falling man is on the door. The stop sign, unfortunately, I haven't been able to update today.
Did we look at the environment? Was the floor dry?
The floor is dry. The environment is clutter-free.
Okay. Are we aware of any mobility issues?
Patient has been assessed by PT. Patient was recommended to use a walker and be a one-person assist because she's unsteady. Mrs. Smith, did you use a walker?
No, I forgot. I'm sorry.
All right, let's go outside and debrief. Pharmacy and Dr. Mahaldra have arrived, so let's engage them in our process.
How about medications? Are there any new medication doses? Was he given anything prior to the fall?
I just gave her some Tylenol for a headache, but I don't think that's what contributed.
I reviewed all the medications and the patient is taking Eliquis for AFib, which does put her at a risk for bleeding. She was also started on an antihypertensive medication during this stay. What's her blood pressure? Could she have been lightheaded or dizzy prior to her fall?
I just finished assessing her. Her blood pressure and vital signs were fine. She didn't report any dizziness to me. And personally, I don't see any injuries on her head, but she did again tell me that she thinks she might have hit her head. So let's get a head CT stat, and I'll put the order in for the neuro checks. According to the fall protocol, she's gonna need to be monitored in the ICU overnight at least because of that anticoagulation therapy. So I'll document all of this on the chart and I'll call her family.
Were there any bed alarms in place or chair alarms? Were they set to the correct level?
Yes, bed alarm was set to zone 1.
And I think that's a great opportunity for us. If the patient was an impulsive fall risk, we should always be setting those bed zones to zone 2. If we set our zones for zone 1, it's gonna be too late by the time the patient gets out of bed. We're gonna find that patient on the floor. So that's an opportunity for us to learn from.
Do we think possibly the patient could have used video monitoring? Was he confused or impulsive? Has she been calling for assistance prior to the fall?
She's not been impulsive until today. She's never gotten out of bed without calling before. She's always used the call bell appropriately.
When did the last hourly rounding take place? Was it purposeful?
I rounded at about 12:30, and
at that time, all personal items were within reach. Patient was comfortable and stated she didn't have to use the bathroom at that time.
Did you check that the bed alarm was in place at that time?
I'm not sure. I don't remember. I assumed the bed was on zone 2.
Well, on my rounds this AM, the fall risk assessment was completed. Patient was identified as an impulsive fall risk because the family had told me that she sometimes doesn't always call for assistance. This was communicated to my tech. I had a conversation with Mrs. Smith this morning about why it was so important for her to call when getting out of bed for any or for any assistance. We reviewed the fact that she's on Eliquis, which puts her at risk for bleeding. She confirmed that she understood and would call us. I will complete that post-fall assessment intervention and enter an in-safety event. I also will reassess the patient as an impulsive fall risk, and I will review the possibility for video monitoring. And I'll update the plan of care.
Thank you, everybody, for discussing our opportunities. Johanna and Patrice, let's huddle with our team and explain to them what our learned opportunities were regarding this fall.
Great.
So thank you, everybody.
Great. Thanks.